Hey guys, welcome back to a new video, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can build graphs using Canvas and Draw API. So without wasting any time, let's get started with our project. So in this video I'm going to show you how to build this kind of graph. So for that, first let's create our composable, and the composable name is Bézier curve, and in its parameter I'm going to pass a few things. For x I'm using here x values, type of this thing is a list of integer. Then we are having here y values. So basically this values is actually used to represent the x axis values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Similarly for y we are having 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Type of this thing is a list of integer. Next we are having the actual point that we are going to represent in our graph. Lastly we are having interval. Okay, so let me explain you these values to you with a very simple graph. So this is our sine x graph. Okay, so its interval is 90, so 0, 90, 180, then 270. So in x direction, in x axis the interval is 90, in y axis we have 0.5, then 1, then 1.5, then 2. Similarly, so x values will be used to represent these values 90, 180, 270, 360, etc. For y values we are having here y values, list of integer, that is used to represent 0.51, etc. So now it's time to start with our composable. So in this, first I'm gonna build a box. A modifier, size of this thing is 300 dp. Let me import this dp. We have here content alignment which is on the center. Cool. Now let me minimize this thing. We are having here canvas that has a modifier fill max size. Now in this canvas I'm gonna find two things, x spacing, y spacing. So by multiplying this x spacing and y spacing we will get point in x axis and y axis respectively. So let's do that. So first I'm gonna find the maximum value that we are receiving from x values. It's time to calculate our spacing, so let's do that. So this x spacing, this value is actually used to jump in the values that present in x axis. So due to that reason I'm using this size width, basically the canvas width, and divide this thing with maximum of x. Now we have spacing. Similarly I'm gonna do the same thing for our y. So let's use our y values, grep the maximum, again use a variable naming y spacing, size height, divide this thing with max of y. Okay, so now we do have spacing, x spacing and y spacing. It's time to draw this thing, these values 0 180 270 360. Similarly for the y axis we have having here 0.51. so let's do that. So for that I'm gonna iterate a loop. So index in started from 0 and goes up to the maximum of x, and also I want to use your interval. Let me explain you this thing with this graph. So here first we are receiving 0, so we are having here 0. Okay, next value this loop will give 90 because we are using interval and our interval is 90. So we are receiving the second index and the value of that index is 90. Okay, due to that reason I'm using here interval. So let's draw this text. So to do that I'm using here draw context, canvas, native canvas, draw text. Okay, so if our index is equivalent to 0, on that case I'm gonna use here empty string, else I'm using the index values. Cool. Next we have to pass our x coordinate and y coordinate. So for x coordinate I'm using my x spacing and multiply this thing with index. So this will give me the x coordinate. Next we are going to find the y coordinate. So it's very easy, you can use your size or height. So eventually it will point to the bottom. So now it's time to pass paint in our draw text function. So let's design paint on the top, and I'm gonna call this text paint. Use here paint, and this paint is coming from android.graphics. Apply scope, text size let's use here 24s, and color of this thing is black. Convert this thing into ARGB. Let's use it. So text paint. Okay, so we are done with our x axis values. Similarly I'm going to do the same thing for y axis. So for index in 0 to max of y, okay, and I want to jump with this interval. So you can use draw context canvas, native canvas. So we are having here draw text. So if our index is equivalent to 0, you can use your empty string, else you can use index.toString. So this time we have to pass our x-axis. Now the x-axis remain constant, which is 0f. Next we are going to pass the y-coordinate. So this time y-coordinate is coming from size height, so we have to subtract y spacing times index to our size height, because our top left corner is actually used to represent the origin. This is the reason why I'm using here this logic. Lastly, we are going to pass our text paint. Okay, so now I'm gonna create preview for this composable. So at the bottom I'm having a composable, and this composable name is Bézier preview. In this I'm gonna use my Bézier curve. So for the x value, so basically I have these values, so I'm gonna simply copy paste those values in here. Okay, and at the top I'm gonna use your preview, show background to true. All right, so now in this canvas I'm gonna add padding of 12 dp. all right, so let's see its preview. There we go, this is our preview. We have here 10 20 30 40 50 60 70 next direction, similarly for the y direction, because in the preview I'm using here interval 10. Let's say I'm using here 20. As you can see, now we have 20, 40, 60, 80, 100 and 120. So due to this reason, I'm using here interval. Cool, so now it's time to draw small circle corresponding to this point that we are passing over here. So use here points for each index, a value, and rename this thing from I to index. So first let's calculate the x coordinate. So this x coordinate will be calculated with the help of x spacing. Multiply this thing with x values corresponding to this index. Next we are going to calculate our y coordinate. So you can calculate this thing from size height, subtract this thing with y spacing, multiply this thing with this value. So we have our x coordinate and y coordinate. Now I'm going to draw a circle. So color is blue and radius is 10f. Lastly we have the center offset. I use x comma y. Now I'm going to open the preview. So this is our preview. Here you can see we have x y values. So 1, 1, this will be multiplied by 10, eventually it will become 10, 10, and the value of 10, 10 is 0. There we go, 0. Second we have 54, so 20, 20 is 54. So yeah, this will work. Now it's time to draw the Bézier curve. So Bézier curve will eventually meet all of these points. So let's see how we can do it. So for that, first I'm gonna store these two values in the list. Coordinate mutable list of type of this thing is pointf. So pointf is used to store two point x and y coordinate. So let's see how we can do it. So here I'm using coordinate and add a new point f, x comma y. So now we do have all the coordinate in this coordinate variable. It's time to draw the Bézier curve. So first let me show you what is Bézier curve. So for that I'm gonna fetch this Wikipedia page for you. So this is our cubic Bézier curve. Okay, so if you want to draw curve between point P0 to P3, shape is controlled by the two points P1 and P2, and we will call this point as control points. So we are going to write a generalized logic which is used to calculate these two points P1 and P2. So let's see how we can do it. So for that we have a formula, and the formula is this. So if you are drawing a curve from point P0 to P1, so in order to get this C1, we have this formula. In order to get this C2, I mean control point 2, we have this formula. So let's see how to use this formula. For that, I'm gonna create a variable, and this variable name is control point. Calculate control point and pass your coordinates. Okay, let me use here small o. So now simply press Alt Enter to create this function. Instead of coordinate, I'm gonna call this points, and my return type of list of pair that contain two control point. Okay, so in this function, I'm gonna create a variable naming control point. Type of this thing is mutable list of pair that contain point f, comma point f. So in this, I'm gonna perform a loop. So for I in one until the points size. So first, I'm gonna grab three points, the previous point, current point, and next point. So let's do that. So first we have a previous. This previous will be coming from our points.get I minus one. Next we have our current one. So use your points get I. Lastly, the next one. So use point dot get or null, because sometimes it will give null. So use your I plus one. Now we have all the three points. It's time to use the formula and calculate the C1 and C2. So for C1, I'm using here point F. Now it's time to calculate the X coordinate. So previous X plus current X minus previous X, and divide this thing with 3. Okay, so this will give us the X coordinates. Similarly for the Y, use previous Y plus current Y, subtract this thing with previous Y coordinate, and divide this thing with 3. So now we have our C1, I mean the first control point. Now it's time to calculate the second control point. So this will depend on the next. So next, sometime it will give null. To do that reason, I'm gonna use here question mark dot let operator. Next, if this value is null, I'm handling the null case over here in this run. So let's see how we can calculate this thing. So point f current x, next x minus previous x, divide this thing with 3f. Okay, similarly for the y, use current y minus next y, subtract your previous y, and divide this thing with 3. Now what will happen if this next is null? So for that, again I'm gonna create here point f. So for the x coordinate, I'm using here previous dot x minus current x minus previous x, divide this thing with 3. Previous y minus current y minus previous y divide by 3. It's a formula, okay? Now I'm going to add this C1 and C2 in my control point list. So let's do that. Control point, add, create a pair, add your first control point and second control point. At the end of this function, I'm gonna return this control points. So now we have all the control point in this variable. It's time to use it. So for that, let's create a path. Make sure this path is coming from androidx compose UI graphics. Apply. So first I'm gonna reset everything. Next, I want to move my brush from origin to a specific location. So move to, so we will move to coordinate first X, coordinate first Y. Okay, now it's time to use our cubic 2 function, which is actually used to draw the Bezier curve. So for that, I'm using here a loop point in 1 until my coordinate size. Okay, so first I'm gonna fetch my control point. So use your control points get, simply use the point. Next I'm gonna use here cubic 2. So first we have to pass our C1, then C2, and lastly the actual point. So for that I'm using here control point first X, control point first Y. So this is my first control point. Next we are going to pass the second control point. So control point second X, control point second Y, lastly the actual coordinate. So this coordinate is coming from coordinates dot get, use here point dot X, coordinate dot get, use here point dot Y. So yeah, that's it for the path. Now it's time to use this path. So to do that, I'm using here draw path, pass your path in this. Next I'm gonna pass here color, so color is blue. Lastly I'm gonna pass this style, so style is stroke, width of this stroke is 12f. Okay, so let's see it works or not. So open up the preview. All right, so here we have a problem and I think I got the problem. So here we can't use point, we have to use here point minus. So let's see whether it works or not. Yeah, there we go. So now we have this Bézier curve. Cool, so let's change the color from blue to red. Okay, so there we go, this is our Bézier curve. All right, so now I'm going to add here animation. So for that, on the top I'm gonna create here a variable, and the variable name is animation progress. Remember, this is a animatable 0f. okay, so initial value is 0f. Let me import this thing. Okay, now I'm gonna use your launch effect and I want to execute this block only one time. Animation progress animate to, and my target value is 1f, and I want to also specify my animation specification. So I'm using here twin of 2 seconds. So duration of this twin is 2 seconds. So to perform animation, we'll use here path measure. So let's use here path measure. We have to pass our path in this. So let's use this thing below our path so that it is accessible. Okay, so now in this you can pass your path. And here we have, so the next parameter is force closed. So I'm using here false. Okay, so here we have a problem, and the problem is requirement of this thing is Android graphic path, but we are sending here AndroidX compose UI graphic path. So what you can do, you can use your extension as Android path. Okay, so now we do have our path measure. Next, it's time to create animation path. With the help of android.graphicPath, you can generate it. Now it's time to use our path measure. So path measure, we have here get segment. If you open up the parameters, so we have here start D, stop D, destination, and start with move to. So for the start D, I'm gonna use here 0f. Next we will use here path measure dot length and multiply this thing with animation progress value. Next we have destination. So in this place I'm gonna use my animation path. So next parameter is start with move to. Yes, I'm using here. Lastly, you can use this animation path here. So let's create a new path object. Use here apply scope function and add the path that you are receiving in a form of animation path, and convert this thing into compose path. All right, so we are done with this animation. Now let's open up the preview and use this interactive mode. Okay, so let's change this thing. There we go, you can see over here, this is the animation. So all right, that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed a lot. It's a very cool video. By the way, if you have any doubt, you can write that doubt in the comment box. I will reply you. And if you want anything else regarding this thing, you can also write that thing in the comment box. We will meet in our next video where we will discuss something new about Android. Till that, goodbye.